Hey everybody, Erica Serwin here from Pink Bucker Designs, and it's day one of my 12 days of Christmas countdown. I do a 12-day series every year where I bring you two projects each day, each featuring a different Christmas or holiday stamp set from our mini catalog. Day one is today, and we are using the Sparkling Snowflakes. I love a good snowflake stamp set. I love to emboss snowflakes, and I found these snowflake brownies, these Little Debbie snowflake brownies this year. So these were kind of my inspiration. They've got some blue sugar crystals on top. So that's kind of where I went with this. So let's, what should we make first? Let's do the card first and we'll do the Little Debbie brownie holder second. All right, I'm gonna bring my grid paper over. We've got three different stamp sizes here. We've got, you know, Papa Bear, Mama Bear, and Baby Bear. And you can stamp these in any order that you want, any color that you want. I am using Night of Navy, Blueberry Bushel, and Balmy Blue. Blueberry Bushel is kind of my main color, so I'm going to start with that. And I'm going to stamp it just, I don't know, a few times around. I like it. I like for them to be off set on the page, some too, like that. Let's do the Knight of Navy, and I'm just gonna do a couple of Knight of Navy because it's really dark and I don't want to have too much dark blue. Maybe a little bit on each side, and they can overlap too, like that. Okay, and then we'll do Balmy Blue for the little guy. Let's see. All right, there we go. Just, you know, stamp it so that it feels right. I kind of just know, like I feel that, oh, you know, that's even, that's good. It's spread out enough. And once you get to that point, you're going to get a Stampin' Blend. This is my dark blueberry bushel, and I'm going to use the brush end to flick some ink on there like that. All right. And now we're going to emboss it with the Snowflake Sky embossing folder. Whoops, I just dropped it. I'm gonna have a complete supply list over on my blog, as well as the measurements. And at the end of the 12 days, I'm actually gonna have a PDF with all 24 projects typed up in a tutorial as well. So make sure you check back on my blog for the next few weeks. And let me make sure I have that up right. When you put this in here, you wanna have the Stampin' Up! Logo up and your front of your cardstock facing up, okay? I just got busy talking and forgot to say that. You want to check back out on my blog over the next few weeks for more Christmas projects, and that PDF will be available at the end. There we go. Now, you can't see it too much. Look on the back. See that texture? But it just adds a little more texture to our background that we've created. Now, I also have a piece of Balmy Blue, and I'm going to emboss that as well. And our embossing folders have a line there that helps you line your cardstock up. Make sure that you've got it straight. And on these embossing folders with a cut and emboss machine, you're going to use plate one and plate four. All right, look at that. That's really pretty. All right, let's move this guy out of the way. And we can start layering these things. I've got a blueberry bushel. It's kind of a tongue twister. A blueberry bushel mat that I am going to adhere this to. Right there. And then we're gonna take that piece of embossed Balmy Blue and put that across. And I've made it a little bit too long. That's okay, we'll just snip it off. And then I'm gonna grab my silver trimmed ribbon. This is beautiful ribbon. And we're gonna tie that around. and finish with a bow over here on the left side. See if I can get that. Come on, there we go. Okay, and then you want to cut your ends off at an angle like that. All right, I have a basic white card base, and I can't remember, did I put this on with dimensionals? I did. I don't know why I even questioned that. I always put everything on with dimensionals. I love using dimensionals. Okay, put that right there. And then let's do our stamping. I have a stylish shaped circle. This one is about 2 1/8 inch wide. There's several in the stack, but that one's 2 1/8 inch. We're gonna get that medium snowflake and our blueberry bushel. Let's see, is this the medium or is this a large? Let's see, let me make sure. I think maybe I used the large. Let's try and see. Blueberry bushel. Yeah, it's the large snowflake. Okay, and then the sentiment I am using says, make the season sparkle. And we're gonna stamp that in balmy blue right there. And we're gonna layer these up. We'll put a dimensional right in the middle. Put that right across our snowflake. And then two dimensionals on the back. And we're gonna put that right there, kind of overlapping that ribbon. And then I added a few of these sequins. These are our neutral sequins. I believe that's what they're called. Neutrals, adhesive back sequins. And I'm gonna use these white ones. And I'm just gonna, again, just kind of sprinkle them around, no rhyme or reason, just until I feel like I have enough. Maybe one more over there. All right, now on the inside of your card, don't forget on the inside of your card and on your envelope, you can carry over your design like that. Let's add a few of the small ones too. Balmy blue. There we go. And a beautiful card for Christmas. All right, now let's make a treat to go with it. All right. Grab your Simply Scored. You know what? I'm going to close these up here. We don't want a disaster. All right, Simply Scored, and you're going to need a piece of 5.5, a piece of blueberry bushel that measures 5.5 by 7.5. You can get two of these out of one sheet. On the long side, we're going to score it at 1, 3 1/4, 4 1/4, and 6 1/2. And then on the short side, we're gonna score it at 1 4.5. Now, before we do anything else, grab that snowflake again, and let's just stamp snowflakes all over. Okay, and you can turn them. They don't all have to be going the same direction. I don't know why I was making them all seem like they should go the same direction, but they don't need to. Okay, have them going off the edge. Let's see, I need to bring back my scrap paper so I can stamp off the edge like that. All right, I think that's good. Now grab your bone folder and you want to burnish those lines, get them nice and crisp. Like that. All right, now our piece is symmetrical on both sides, so it doesn't matter which side you start on. But on one of the sides, you're gonna cut off both of these corners. And when you do, cut that a little bit at an angle right there. All right, so do that and that. Okay, now cut the score lines along the long side and cut the corners off of the square tabs. So snip. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. All right, so there is what your piece looks like. Grab your adhesive of choice. I think since I have it here, I'm just going to use Stamp and Seal. Liquid glue is normally my favorite with 3D boxes. All right, so we're going to fold that in like that. All right, so that's how it lays down flat, actually. And that's what your box looks like. So decide which is the top and which is the bottom. I like to have that where those edges meet, have that as the back, okay? So I'm gonna fold in the back tab first. Sorry. The side tabs first. Then we're gonna fold in that back tab. And you're gonna need to take your bone folder, push that down, and then the front tab. So you have those rounded edges on all four of your sides. Over here, you've got these edges of your cardstock. All right, so now let's put our brownie in like that. And I'm not gonna seal up the top. We're gonna tie it together with ribbon, but we wanna fold it in the same way. Sides, back, front. Okay, now let's see, do I have enough ribbon on this spool? Yeah, it's gonna be close. Let's see. Take your ribbon around the front. You know what? I don't think I'm gonna have enough. I have another spool sitting right here. Let's just use that. Take your ribbon. Around. Tie a bow. This ribbon's really easy to tie. It's just real light and airy. Okay, again, let's cut those at an angle. All right, so there's the front. Isn't that beautiful blueberry bushel with that silver? We're gonna carry on that silver theme by embossing our snowflake. All right, I've got my stylus shaped circle and I am going to emboss that large snowflake. Let's rub it with your embossing buddy. That's gonna remove any static cling that might be on there. And ink up in your Versamark and stamp that right there. All right, and then we're gonna set that down into our tray. And add in our silver embossing powder. Whoops, I knocked too much of it off. All right, now grab your little reverse tweezers and hit it with your heat tool, and it's gonna turn nice and shiny. It's gonna be a metallic embossing powder. All right, there we go. Now let's stamp the sentiment on here. We're gonna actually emboss this one too, I forgot. Let's open that back up. Let it snow. This one we're gonna do in white, which I have in a container. All right, and then grab your heat tool again And this one's not going to be as shiny. It is going to be shiny-ish, but more bright white. Okay, now we're going to add this on with a dimensional right there in the middle, right there in the middle like that. And then all you have to do is attach it, overlapping that ribbon like that. Gorgeous. That blueberry bushel with the silver is absolutely gorgeous. All right, let's look at our projects. There you have them, a nice little gift for someone and a matching card. Make sure you click the link here on YouTube to go back to my blog. I'll have the measurements and a supply list for you. And check back every day for a new set of projects. Bye, everybody.